So, today I would like to present you my frictionless automatic two-gear box design. I have the input down here, and usually when there's low load on the output, then the torque is transmitted directly to the still standing differential gearboxes. But if the torque on the output is increased, then this flywheel on the side will start rotating, and then I have a second gear engaged with a higher gearing ratio. So this gearbox adjusts to the output torque and accordingly increases the gearing ratio. So why do we need this anyway? The LEGO Technic motors have the highest efficiency at a certain speed, and if the load on the output with the respecting gearing ratio becomes too high, the efficiency drops significantly, and it can even lead to stalling of the motor. So to demonstrate this, when I have this motor with nothing attached, I can almost get it to a complete stall. And yeah, then the efficiency is really low. For example, if you have a vehicle which is driving on the ground on regular conditions, but then enters the ramp, this can lead to complete stop of the vehicle. So in order to circumvent this, you can use a gearbox, and an automated gearbox like this one automatically adjusts the gear to a higher ratio, so you have always the best efficiency for your motor. And yeah, so this design, like other designs, uses two differentials which are connected here on the side with three gears, and usually the path from the input here, the black axle, to the output on top is just directly through the differential. So the housings are standing still, and only the bevel gears inside the differentials are rotating. And then you have a one-to-one gearing ratio. And there's a second part on the side, which has a other gearing ratio with the higher torque output. And usually these two paths are both possible. So when I move the input, then there can be a mix of both paths. And many designs use some kind of restriction for the second path, which is only lifted when the load on the output becomes higher. So one possibility to do this is to increase some friction in the system. So for example, somewhere connect a gear with a friction pin. So this gear blocks the second path, and it will only rotate against the friction when the load is high enough on the output. But the downside of this is that you always have friction in the second gear, and you lose some power with it. Another possibility is to use some kind of flexible element, for example a spring, but this spring is linear, and it's very difficult to translate the rotating motion or block the rotating motion with a linear spring. So usually you have to build some sophisticated mechanism around to block the second path. But there's also a third way to hinder the movement of the second path, and this is by having some mass attached, in this case this flywheel. So the flywheel, due to its high mass, has some resistance against acceleration. So and then, of course, you have some friction in the system with the axle bearings. And usually this mass resistance of this flywheel is big enough to stop it from rotating. And only when the load on the output is getting high enough, this acceleration resistance will be overcome. And then the flywheel starts rotating and the second path is accessible. And when the load on the output is lowered, then due to the friction of the axles, the little friction of the axles, this flywheel will stop turning again, and then you have the 1-to-1 gearing ratio again. So with this design, you have a very smooth transmission from the first gear to the second gear. And it's quite compact. You could exchange this gearing ratio also with another gearing ratio. The problem is just that it's 5 axle holes separated, so it's a little bit difficult to find appropriate gearing combinations. So, I hope you like it and see you next time.